Ohio, antiseptic production business is a very profitable one, although it is actually on the high side to make, like very on the high side. The cost of purchasing isopropyl alcohol is quite pricey, and the cost of also purchasing ethanol is quite pricey, but the end result is worth doing it. Check out the smallest container of Dettol in the market and check the price. Then you understand that there is actually profit in making antiseptic liquid and adding to your side hustle. You can actually make this and sell. Trust me. So this is the production we'll be making today. Look at how beautiful it is and attractive and looking like the already known brand. Stay tuned and don't go anywhere. So when people buy antiseptic liquid or make it, the first thing they want to know is, if you add it into water, does it turn creamy like the already known brand? Does it change color? If it doesn't change color, that means it's not original. Don't worry, the formula I'll be sharing with you today will turn creamy, just like you are seeing it on the screen. Just get me 500 grams of Texapon gel and add it to your mixing bowl. Make sure you are not using homemade prepared Texapon. Make sure it's the market grade of Texapon gel. That surfactant is what I need. And then buy half liter of pine oil. Half a liter of pine oil. Please, pine oil is an essential oil. This is what deodorizes, this is what cleans, this is what removes germs. It has a very high power to deodorize whatever you use it to clean. Let's take, for instance, we use it in cleaning your house or you use it in bathing. It can actually remove body odor. I'm telling you the gospel truth. Pine oil is very strong. And it is needed. Now, this is actually the antiseptic of choice. This is chlorxylenol. It comes in liquid, it comes in powder. I will be using the powdered one. You can see me making use of it. It's like a little pellet. It's in powdered form. Some persons don't know how to make use of it. Please note today, learn it today. You can't dissolve chlorxylenol powder in water. It can dissolve in water, it can only dissolve in ethanol. I didn't add any water in this production for now. You just add it immediately if you have finished adding your pine oil. You will notice that it's not dissolving. Then you add in 2 liters of isopropyl alcohol. Exactly 2 liters of isopropyl alcohol. It will now, the chlorxylenol will start dissolving, will start breaking down gradually. But it dissolves more if you should add ethanol into the production. Please note me, don't use water to dissolve your chlorxylenol powder. It will mess up your production. Do as well to follow me gradually. Please just try to follow me gradually. I started up with dissolving Texapon gel and pine oil. Then I followed in with isopropyl alcohol, then I'm now going in with ethanol 2 liters. When you start adding the remaining part of the ethanol 2 liters, you will notice that the chlorxylenol will start dissolving. Look at it, just look at the bucket. It's almost as if it's not there anymore. You understand? So the you add 2 liters of IPA, 2 liters of ethanol. If you want to use a whole of 2 liters of IPA, isopropyl alcohol, you can go ahead. But IPA is on the high side. It is also known as rubbing alcohol. But you actually need a combination of the two of them to have your concentration of denatured alcohol. So the concentration we are making is 50-50. It's 50% alcohol, 50% water. You understand? So for the 4 liters of ethanol we have poured, the 4 liters of alcohol we have added here, we will complement it with 4 liters of water. You just can't leave it like this. So make sure the water you are measuring, you boil it, you cool it down, you filter it, make sure it's very neat. Please, if it is possible, make use of deionized water or distilled water. Just make sure the water you are making use of is as clean as possible. Remember, you are using this, you are using this for first aid, you are using it for bathing, you are using it for sanitary purposes. So let's color it. There are different ways you can color your Dettol. You can use red oxide. It's an oxide color. It dissolves very well both in water and oil. This is Dettol caramel color. It comes in liquid form. Or you can buy the popular brown water soluble color. Brown water soluble color. They will all give you the color outcome you want. In case the person, the vendor you are buying from does not have caramel color. This is actually the color, this caramel liquid color might be scarce, but you can buy the brown color, the brown water soluble color. You can also buy the red oxide. Some of them call it magic color, but any of them can work for you. So far, it's tending towards the red, dark red, or it's tending towards the dark brown. You are good to go. So look at how beautiful the production is. Can you see how the coloring is? I didn't color it too dark. I made sure the coloring is as light as possible so that it can match some of the existing and popular brands in the market. And then you are good to go. It's very swift and fast. Before you know, you are done with your production. Once you are done, just stir very well and cover it till like the next day before you bottle. I would suggest that all the containers you are making use of to pour in your antiseptic liquid, try as much as possible to sterilize them. Wash them with hot water. Clean them very well. Wash them with brushes. Make sure it is very clean. Arrange them. Allow all of them to drain water perfectly before you make use of them. You need to be as tidy as possible, as sterile as possible when you are making use of when you are making this production, because most of the persons that you are selling this to might be in the hospital. Maybe your target point might be hospitals. Maybe your target point might be schools, churches, or homes. The people that make use of it in their homes to bathe, to wash their little ones, to add into their bathing water. Just try as much as possible to make sure your production is as clean as possible.